Namaskar and welcome again to Planet To Soul Astrology. So friends, today we are going to discuss about profession of spouse through Navmansh Kundali. So basically we had many sessions connected to Navmansh chart and how will be nature, characteristic, Dharakarak planet, Atmakarak. See, still so many things are balanced to discuss, but still, we always have one query or one thing. Each and everyone who are going to get married or who are in some relationship, definitely they would like to know that how will be profession or what will be profession of my spouse, because while doing consultations also many people ask that what will be spouse's profession along with character and nature of spouse. So there are many methods, techniques to see profession of a spouse through your chart, but today I'm going to discuss one of the important technique, and this I have researched and I have found it very much accurately most of the time working in many charts, and I would like to share with you all. So yes, before starting, let me tell you all that thank you for subscribing my channel, and yes, waiting for more subscriptions, and yes, do share and like my channel. And also, if you all are interested in daily updates regarding Jyotish articles, so definitely you please visit my page, which is Sunilee Jani Pawar Jyotish Prabodhini. And also I am available on Instagram. There also I have started daily horoscope, daily predictions, and please suggest me there also what you would like to get from me. So please find me on Instagram also, Sunilee Jani Pawar. So yes, profession of spouse through Navmansh Kundali. So now, first of all, what you have to see that where your seventh lord of D1 chart is going in Navmansh Kundali, and wherever that lord is posited in Navmansh chart, that is seventh lord of D1, wherever is going in Navmansh chart, from that house, whichever sign and planet are posited 10th to it will definitely give you major clue related to your spouse's profession. I'll give you one simple example. If your seventh lord is say sun, and if in Navmansh Kundali, if it is posited in fifth house of your chart, right, that is in say for example Cancer sign in fifth house, so the fifth house, from there you will count 10th position, so there comes Aries sign. So one can say if no planets are posited in Aries sign in Navmansh Kundali, so definitely one can say that this person's spouse will be connected to technical profession, medicine, or whatever Mars connected, or very much brave personality, or we can say that this person will be connected to Martian profession. Or if any planet is also posited there, say for example if Mercury is posited there in Aries sign, then one can say that this person's spouse will be connected to finance, accounts, we can see that more of calculations and technicality also, computers also. And if it is Venus 10th to your 7th lord, then definitely you can say that more connected to designing, architecture, or Venus related thing, food line, travels. And then you have to see that which zodiac sign is posited from your 7th lord in Navmansh Kundali. Friends, I have found it working fantastically in maximum of charts, and I want you all to do research and do check it on your charts as well as your known charts, so that this can become a strong thing, that yes, at least the basic, the major thing we can rule out from one's chart, that what type of profession your spouse will be having, you know. So I will give you another example. If your seventh lord, say, is Sagittarius sign in D1 chart, okay, so if you are a Gemini ascendant, so definitely Sagittarius sign is going to fall in your seventh house. So lord of Sagittarius is Jupiter. So in D1 chart, Jupiter becomes your seventh lord, right? And in D9 chart, if this Jupiter is going in Aries sign, right? So from Aries, you have to see the 10th position. So from Aries, the 10th position comes Capricorn sign, right? So this person will be very much connected to Saturnine work, right? So it could be like public sector work, or it can be construction work, because here in Aries sign, Jupiter is connected. Legal department, or say law and order, or Saturnine thing, or researcher or scientist, so many things you can come to know. And then you have to see that whether any planet is posited in Capricorn sign, then again you have to judge that yes, whichever planet, that is Capricorn, Saturn were posited, and planet posited in Capricorn sign, whichever is more strong in a chart, then definitely connected to that spouse's profession will be decided. Now people say that many females or many people are having own business, so from there this only we can just rule out. If Jupiter is very powerful in 10th from your 7th lord, or Jupiterian sign is there and Jupiter in that Navamsha chart is very powerful, then according to that, see, that is another deeper thing we have to judge. This is just a fundamental thing I am trying to convey. Many are housewives, like, you know, in male chart, and if females are not working and they are housewives, so definitely I get many queries related to this also, that so maybe whatever sign is posited, that sign related work that spouse will be definitely expert into. Like if Venus is there, if moon sign is there, or planet is there, then definitely she will be a fantastic cook. She can start her cooking business or food line. She can start, she can be good in technicality, she can be good in designing. If Mercury is there, she will be good in communication. So it is not there that if somebody is not going for work and not earning money, then what is the use of seeing profession of a spouse if no one is working? No, you have to see what quality your spouse is having towards his or her career. So friends, do check in your charts and let me know in comment section that whether it is implementing in your chart or no. So stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology, and as I always say, Sabka Mangal Ho, may all be blessed. Namaste.